हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू अवर न्यू वीडियो। सो टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज हाउ टू मेक लॉट्स ऑफ मनी इन ऑनलाइन स्टॉक ट्रेडिंग। सो बिफोर वी स्टार्टेड आवर वीडियो, मेक श्योर दैट यू सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन। सो हाउ टू मेक मनी इन ऑनलाइन स्टॉक ट्रेडिंग। इन्वेस्टिंग इन स्टॉक मार्केट कैन बी अ ग्रेट वे टू हैव योर मनी मेक मनी, particularly in today's economic climate where saving accounts and long-term banknotes do not offer significant returns. So, number one is research current trends. There are many reputable sources that report on market trends. You may want to subscribe to a stock trading magazine such as Kiplinger. You could also follow blogs written by successful markets analytics, such as Abnormal Returns, Deal Block, Foot and Calculated Risks. Select a trading website. Some of the top related sites include Sportrade, Option House, TD, Ameritrade, Motif Investing and TradeKing. Be sure that you are aware of any transaction fees or percentages that will be charged before you decide on a site to use. Be sure the service you use is reputable. Select a service that has amenities such as a mobile phone app. Or number third is create an account with one or more trading websites. You are unlikely to need more than one, but you may want to start with two or more so that you can later narrow your choice to site like the best. Be sure to check out the minimum balance requirement for each site. Starting with a particularly small account like $1,000 may limit your assets in trading platforms. Practice trading before you put real money in some websites such as Scouted, Elite, SureTrader and Options House offer a virtual trading platform where you can experiment for a while to access your instincts without putting actual money. Of course, you can't make money this way, but you also can't lose money. Trading is the manner we'll get to your used to method and types of decisions you will be faced with when trading, but overall it's a poor representation of actual trading. So additionally, trading with virtual money will not prepare you for the stress of trading with your real money. Choose reliable stocks. You have a lot of choices, but unlimitedly you want to buy stock from companies that dominate their niche, offer something that people consistently want, have a recognizable brand. Look into a company's public financial reports to evaluate how profitable they are. Complete financial information about any publicly traded company while visiting their website and locating their most recent annual report. Look at the company's worst quarter on record and decide if the risk of repeating that quarter is worth the potential of profit. Research company's leadership, operating costs, and debt analysis their balance sheet and income statement and determine if they are profitable or have a good chance to be in the future. Listen to a company's earnings conference call. First, analyze the company's quarterly earning release that is posted online, another press release about an hour about the call. Buy your first stock. When you are ready to take their plunge and buy a small number of reliable stocks, the exact number will depend on your budget, but shoot for at least two companies that are well known, we have established trading histories and good reputations are generally the most stable stocks and a good place to start. It is reasonable for an investor to begin trading with as little as $1,000. You just have to be careful to avoid large transaction fees as they can easily eat up to gain about half a small account balance. Invest mostly in mid-cap and large-cap companies. Mid-cap companies are those that have a market capitalization between $2 and $10 billion. large cap companies have a market cap larger than $10 billion. Market capitalization is calculated by multiplying a company's stock price by the number of shares outstanding. Number 8 is monitor the markets daily. Remember, the cardinal rule in stock trading is to buy the low and sell high. You should sell the stock and reinvest the profit in other lower priced stocks. Mutual funds are actively managed by a professional fund manager and include a combination of stocks. This will diversify with investment in such sectors as technology, retail, financial, energy, or foreign companies. You want to sell your stocks at their peak based on past history. If you sell the stocks for more money than you bought them for, you make money. The bigger to increase from when you bought them to when you sold them, the more money you make. Do not sell in panic when your stock you have drops lower than the price you bought it for. Your instinct may be to get rid of it while there is a possibility that it can keep falling and never come back up. You should consider the possibility that it may rebound. Selling for loss is not always the best idea. Study the fundamental and technical market analysis methods. There are the two basic models of understanding the stock market and anticipating prices changes. The model you use will determine how to make decisions about what stocks to buy and when to buy and sell them. A fundamental analysis makes decisions about a company based on what they do, their character and reputations. A technical analysis looks at the entire market and what motivates investors to buy and sell stocks. Many investors use a combination of these two methods to make informed investment decisions. Some investors known as income investors prefer to invest almost entirely in dividable playing stocks. This is a way that your stock holders can make money even or if they don't appreciate the price dividend. Our company's profit paid directly to stock holders quarterly. Reinvest money. When you sell your stock, hopefully for a lot more than you bought it for, you should roll your money and profits into buying these new stocks. If you can make a little money every day or every week, you are on your way to stock market success. Invest in an IPO, initial public offering. An IPO is the first time a company issues stock. That can be great time to buy a stock in a company you believe will be successful, as the IPO offering prices often but not always turns out to be the lowest price even for a company's stock. So guys, this is the information that I have shared with you. So if you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon. Stay blessed. Goodbye.